Good morning to one and all present here. I, Abhishek Bajaj, student of the HSC second semester, feel extremely privileged to welcome you all for the second edition of World's first 10-day Digital Life International Conference, ICANN4. It's been organized by Delhi Metropolitan Education in collaboration with the School of Communication and Creative Arts, Deakin University, Melbourne, Australia. It's a matter of great pride for us to announce that ICANN4 is being supported by Indian Council of Social Science Research, ICSSR. The highlights of previously organized ICANNs are the ICANN1 was conducted on the theme India and Changing Aspects of News, which was held in March 2018. ICANN2 was all about Indian cinema and alternative networks that was conducted in November 2018. Theme of ICANN3 was issues of community, agenda and news, # Conference for Change. And now, here we are, ICANN4, World's first 10-day Digital Life International Conference. Theme for this year, conference is Information, Communication and Artificial Networks. And the # for the conference is Communication Redefined. I would like to thank our knowledge partners, KR Mangalam University, Gurugram, Haryana, Adamas University, Kolkata, Makhanlal Chaturvedi National University of Journalism and Mass Communication, Bhopal, Vigyan Prasar Government of India. I would also like to thank our academic partner, Department of Communication and Journalism, Guwahati University, and our international partners, Institute of International Journalism, E.W. Scripps School of Journalism, Ohio University, USA, and the Positive Times as a media partner. Participation of about 60 eminent scholars from the 5 continents and 11 countries, namely India, South Korea, Malaysia, Singapore, Bangladesh, USA, Mexico, France, Italy, Australia, and Ghana. More than 100 media educators, researchers have gathered to present their papers in the conference. 36 live sessions, including 9 technical sessions, 3 workshops, 7 panel discussions, 3 special sessions, and 10 masterclasses. All 9 technical sessions are being chaired and co-chaired by women scholars representing different states of the country. I would also like to extend my gratitude to SPARC, the Student Council of DME Media School, for students with positive attitude and resonating communication. Special thanks to Journalism at DME. It's the official newsletter of DME Media School. The fortnightly publication covers all the major activities happening in and out of the campus. It is a student-centric newsletter and carried out entirely by them under the supervision of faculty members. And now, DME TV, the official YouTube channel of DME, where you can find the playlist related to all the sessions and lecture series, film festivals, and even conference. For more information, follow us on our social media handles. Links are being shared in the chat box. And now, let me introduce you to the guest of the day. Today, we have Professor Arya with us. Professor Umesh Arya is a media teacher, life coach, healer, and a corporate trainer. He is also the Dean Faculty of Media Studies at Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, HISA. He is a teaching career of 22 years and has 40 publications in national and international journals. He specializes in information power searching and ICT application in communication. He has delivered more than 3,500 lectures and 350 webinars on various topics ranging from technological application to neuro-linguistic programming, NLP. And his PhD findings are published on the website of United Nations Public Administrations Network UNPAM. And Professor Arya has copyrighted one term, TechVac, Technological Vacation. He aspires to leverage the online education methodology with his own channel on YouTube, which has more than 350 videos on soft skills and hard skills. He has developed a lot of key manuals for the teachers on these topics. Dr. Arya has delivered lectures on EduSet Information Overload, Media Literacy, Effective Searching Techniques, Google Power Searching Techniques, Waste Reduction in Learning, etc. Professor Arya has served Deputy Director of Academic Staff College in his university. He has delivered lectures in the University of Florida and Zanesville, USA. He visited a few countries, US, UK, the Netherlands, Germany, and Belgium. For his academic pursuits, Professor Arya is an International Yoga Alliance for Ministry and of Ayush certified yoga and meditation teacher of the art of living. He is certified therapist for many psychological ailments like phobia, anxiety, OCD, etc. He is a certified hypnotherapist and past life regression therapist. He is a certified reflexologist He's a certified NLP, neuro-linguistic program communication coach, and he has treated thousands of people affected by mental health issues. He is now a corporate trainer and is on the panel of many blue chip corporate companies. And now Professor Arya, with this new circumstances, like he handled Jindal Stainless Steel, HCL Coking Technologies, Wipro, etc. Professor Arya has invented patented ECA therapy, emocardiation. This therapy allows people to create the enabling circumstances for their careers, health, relationships, and finance, etc. Professor Arya is also a trainer of Google News initiatives like India Training Network, and his main passion is to coach people, explore the quantum possibilities inside them. Now, I would like to invite Professor Dr. Ambri Saxena, Dean DME Media School, Director DME Media Studios, and Production Director International Relatives, Delhi Metropolitan Education, Noida, to give his opening remarks.
Thank you, Abhishek. I welcome everybody this morning on the fourth day of the conference on 4th of July. A number of sessions have already happened, master classes, panel discussions, workshops, special sessions. So in continuation with that, this morning session is with Professor Umesh Arya, and that is on debunking misinformation. This is something with which every one of us are aware of. Gradually, slowly, this has turned this misinformation or the fake news, as we commonly call it, it has turned into a very, very serious issue in our society. And since the time this COVID-19 is struck in March last year, the problem has increased manifold. The way the misinformation problem is identified on the social media, everybody is concerned of, not only the media educators, researchers, or the media students, but also the common people are affected by it. Even the government is concerned on this issue. That is how the government has come out with the IT rules and regulations recently, which have been imposed by social media organizations. Though there is a diff with the Twitter and the WhatsApp, there are issues which are being raised with regard to privacy, with regard to the freedom of doing business in a country. I mean, there's a lot of such issues are there. Legally, we look into this, and the Supreme Court is looking into those things. But then when in our day-to-day life, we receive information, and then we pass on that information, we forward that information to our friends, to our colleagues. Now the real problem lies there. We are not in a habit of verifying the fact. We simply forward the messages. Now this is something which we have to learn as to which message is to be believed, which is not to be believed, where the facts are to be checked, and then which information is to be forwarded. Because if we are not cautious of this fact, then we are doing a lot of harm to our society. So this whole session is devoted to this problem, wherein we all expect that Dr. Umesh Arya will tell us not only the magnitude of the problem, but he will also try to provide a solution to this problem as to how we can be beware of this problem and can save our society with the damages which are being caused by this whole means of misinformation. So I stop here because we all are waiting to listen to Dr. Umesh Arya. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for briefing us and enlightening us on the subject. Now, I would like to call Dr. Umesh Arya to take the session carry forward. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good morning to all of you. Good morning again. Okay. So, without taking much of your time, because we are already, me personally is running behind the schedule by at least 5 to 7 minutes, but it's okay. So I'll take not more than 1 hour for that. Huh? Yeah. And today is a different topic, but the rules are the same. Huh? Keep a smile on the face, have a back straight, and listen keenly, and if possible, you can consider switching on your video, right, for the time being. So that's a request. I mean, I can only say that. Okay. So now we are 61 people and okay. So as the agenda has already been set by Professor Amrish and others, that today is the day of debunking misinformation, right? And we will try to do it in a very, very simple way, very nice way. And over a period of time, I have learned that, you know, telling very high sounding things, they don't actually get into the people's head. So I had to, you know, really simplify them like anything. And today I'll try to, you know, convey my message with only one method, and that will be applicable across the board, right? It will debunk information related to text, image, and video, right? So no need to worry, right? Just sit back. I know that you are reeling under the information overload, because these kind of conferences, you really have to burn the midnight oil for that, right? So congratulations to you for that first, and especially Professor Amrish for organizing that year on year. Let's start our morning session then, right? Should we go ahead? Okay. So let me share my screen first and come to the presentation now. This is it. Yeah. So debunking misinformation. Is it clear? Screen, my video, my audio, and my smile. All good. Yeah. Okay. Quadrant, right? So we are going to learn something about, you know, misinformation. Then we will debunk that misinformation. And this training program, very short training program of 1 hour, is brought to you by Google News Initiative India Training Network, right? And I'm representing them now. So let's start. Would you mind if I ask you a few questions before starting? Huh? Yeah. The first question is, are you suffering from information overload, right? You can write in the chat box either yes or no. Sukriti, yes. Manasvi, yes. Very good. Teenam. Mohammed Kamil, yes. In the caps, very good. You are representing at least 4 students now, right? Thank you. Okay. So, yeah, answer would be mostly yes. Huh? And especially within, I mean, in these 10 days, yes. In the capital letters. I can understand. That's good. So, okay, let me unshare my screen and ask you the second question. So I'm asking the question now, and we will come to the cumulative analysis, right? Cumulative analysis after, you know, all the questions they have been answered. So we are all suffering from information overload, right? Okay. Another question is, do you know how to verify a message if you receive some forward on WhatsApp, some Facebook or some other social media? Do you know how to forward that, how to verify that? Okay. Just a note of caution here. If you have attended any workshop like this somewhere, then only you can be confident of, right? That you can verify the message. Otherwise, if you think that you can verify, so sometimes it comes with a pinch of salt, right? Because fake news comes to you in such a, you know, nice format that you have to believe it, right? So I'm waiting for the answers. Do you know how to verify a message? Kuch to likhiye. Undecided, huh? Can't say. Yes, no, can't say, perhaps. Okay. Right, it's okay. No problem. So the silence is half commitment, huh? So we don't know how to verify a message. So I'll take this way. No problem. Now, this is very important. Do you know forwarding unverified info is a crime? Hmm? Okay. Yes, yes. Okay. Now, I have asked the question in the affirmative, actually. So, the answer has to be yes, because now you got a hint that, okay, oh, is it a crime? Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. It's okay. Now, the last question is, अभी इस क्वेश्चन के लिए बहुत ईमानदारी की जरूरत है. प्लीज मैं आपसे मतलब रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि इसका आंसर बिल्कुल ठीक से दें. हाँ, हैव यू एवर फॉरवर्डेड एनी अनवेरिफाइड मैसेज आइदर इंटेंशनली और अनइंटेंशनली? मोहम्मद कामिल, नो, नेवर. ओके. इफ यू आस्क अबाउट मी, आई एम उमेश, Umesh 1.0 before 2018, then my answer would be yes, I have forwarded, but I didn't know that. Unintentionally, I did that, right? After that, reincarnation after 2018, Umesh 2.0, then we learned, oh, this was the misinformation, this was the fake news. We stopped that, right? So, unintentionally, we might have done that, right? So, these were a few questions, and now let's do some cumulative analysis, right? The first question, have you ever... are you the victim of information overload? Answer was yes. Okay. So, when information overload is there, then three things happens. You are under permanent stress, anxiety, and confusion, right? You are not able to decide between the right information and the wrong information, because you are, suppose, reading one message and thousands of messages, they are crying for the attention. So, kitna aap verify karenge usko, right? Isliye, after a certain period of time, you accept everything as it is, right? So this condition is perfect for the fake news mongers, right? They want you to bombard with the information overload, right? So that the line between the genuine one and the fake one, it diminishes, right? And it finishes altogether after a certain period of time, right? Got my point? Huh? Okay. So, recently, I was delivering the same workshop in Punjab University, Chandigarh. So the chairperson told me very, very, you know, very, very minute thing. And I like that. I would like to share here, right? So she said, sir, because the social media platforms, they thrive on the information overload, because that's their economy, right? But the amount of truth cannot be that much, which can fill that much space. Yes or no? So they have to create the variation of the truth then, right? They have to create various combinations of the truth, right? You have to remove something, they have to insert something. And that's why different variants of the truth are there, and that becomes endless, and they are filling the space, right? It's a nice argument now, right? Because going by this philosophy, almost 100% information flowing on the social media, except the verified accounts, it is fake, right? We are taking the definition that, okay, fine, if you have added or deleted even a single word or single sentence, that becomes a misinformation, right? Or the fake news, whatever you can call it, right? So the first condition is satisfied that, okay, we are prone to misinformation, right? I'll use fake news and the misinformation interchangeably. Obviously, the academically, the the terms are different. But उनको आप एक ही समझिए अभी सेशन के लिए, right? Second question was, do you know how to verify a message, right? The answer was deep, एक deep silence, right? It means no, हम नहीं जानते. Fine, ठीक है, it's okay, कोई बात नहीं. अगला question है, do you know forwarding unverified info is a crime? Fortunately, all of you know that it is a crime, right? Okay. Then, have we forwarded any unverified message ever? People were saying no, no, no. Kamil sir said no, never. Capital letters, right? Okay. See, I am asking you unintentionally. क्या आपने कभी किया है? ऐसा हो नहीं सकता, देखिए, right? And if I, tell you about my hundreds of the trainings and the thousands of the participants like this, same answer people gave, right? No, we haven't done it, sir. Hardly any we have, शायद कभी हमने किया हो. Okay. I accept this, right? But मुझे एक बात बताइए, अगर आप लोग नहीं भेजते, वो hundreds and thousands of people जो जिनको मैंने training दिया, वो नहीं करते, कभी भेजते आगे, ये forwards भेजता कौन है फिर? Then aliens तो नहीं भेजते हैं. Who sends these forwards? These are all people like you and me, yes or no? But yes, unintentionally we can do it. It's okay, that's allowed. Don't worry about that, right? So now all these four conditions are not in our favor, right? We don't know how to verify messages. Again, a very slightly negative something on our part. But we know that forwarding fake news is a crime. And हमने शायद कभी ना कभी एक न्यूज तो फॉरवर्ड की है आगे कभी ना कभी अनवेरीफाइड इन्फॉर्मेशन तो फॉरवर्ड किया है राइट right? और इन्फॉर्मेशन ओवरलोड का शिकार हम सभी के सभी हैं. इट मीन्स दिस इज ए परफेक्ट टेम्पलेट फॉर द फेक न्यूज एंड मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन मॉन्गलर्स राइट. ये परफेक्ट टेम्पलेट है, मतलब देर हैज टू बी एनेबलिंग कंडीशंस ना फॉर द मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन टू थ्राइव, इजंट इट? सो दैट्स द परफेक्ट टेम्पलेट जो अभी हम लोगों ने आंसर्स दिए हैं राइट. ओके सो अभी लेट मी शेयर समथिंग फॉर यू एंड यू विल बी सरप्राइज टू नो. या सो द फर्स्ट इज व्हाई वी नीड टू नो अबाउट द मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन. इसके बगैर भी तो लाइफ चल रही है राइट. सो दिस इज माई आई मीन फेवरेट स्टडी विच सेज दैट जो फेक न्यूज होती है ना, जो मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन, इट ट्रेवल्स फास्टर and it goes farther and goes deeper and more broadly than truths in all other categories of information right. iska matlab seedha seedha hindi mein ye hai ki jhoot jo hai na, falsehood hai, wo sach se 6 times faster travel karta hai. This is a finding right, empirically established, 6 times faster travel karta hai. And out of the falsehood, false political news, they are reaching more people faster and it is hitting their networks like anything than any other categories of false information. Could you get my point, right? झूठ जब सच से छह गुना तेज चलने लग जाए एंड वेन आउट ऑफ दैट फॉल्सहुड स्पेशलाइज कैटेगरीज ऑफ यू नो फॉल्स पॉलिटिकल न्यूज इट स्टार्ट्स अफेक्टिंग पीपल देन इट्स अ कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न राइट बिकॉज अवर लाइफ इज बेस्ड ऑन द पॉलिटिकल इंस्टीट्यूशंस. यस और नो, वी आर लिविंग इन द डेमोक्रेसी, क्लियर? सो नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी गुड रीजन दैट वी शुड नो अबाउट द मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन. इसके बगैर लाइफ अभी तक चल रही है बट आगे शायद ठीक से ना चले. दैट्स वाई वी नीड टू learn this right. Okay, we need to stay away from the fake news. Okay, now this slide has got to do something with the answers we gave right. Now these are the sections of Indian Penal Code which have been imposed by the government, by the police, on the journalists right, on the journalists. Mark this word, they have been arrested while spreading the misinformation. Section 153 and 153A. I'll not read the complete text because you know that this is standard law language, that if your message promotes the enmity between different groups on grounds of religion, you know, residence, language, place of birth, this, that, karke, then you will be charged under this, right? Section 505, especially for rumors, right? If you spread rumor and if it can cause public disorder, right? Section 120, criminal conspiracy. Anything can come under criminal conspiracy. Section 34, this is slightly serious. If a particular crime has been committed by, say, 15 people, then all of the 15 people will get the equal amount of sentence, right? It's not that, okay, no, sir, we just helped this much, and he was the main conspirator. No. Section 34 is very clear. Section 499, defamation. If you defame somebody without evidence, with a malicious sentence. Clear? Abhi main aapse ek baat puchunga yahan pe, agar aap अपना चैट में अगर इसको रिप्लाई कर सके तो. इफ वी ऑडिट अवर इंफॉर्मेशन बिहेवियर, वी रीड मैसेज, वी फॉरवर्ड द मैसेज नोइंगली और अननोइंगली, वी आर टचिंग अपॉन दीज आईटी सेक्शंस. यस और नो? अब ये भूल जाइए इसमें कि आप अपने फ्रेंड्स के बीच में मैसेज भेजते हैं या यू हैव अ क्लोज ग्रुप ऑफ योर रिलेटिव्स, इन दैट यू सेंड द मैसेज लाइक दिस फॉर द पीपल, आई मीन जो जिसमें सेक्शन 153 अप्लाई हो रहा है. हम लोग सारा दिन यही तो करते हैं भाई. हाँ, बिकॉज किसी भी पार्टिकुलर स्टेट से, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यूपी एंड बिहार राइट, वेस्ट बंगाल, वी आर इन द हैबिट ऑफ रिडिकुलिंग पीपल. यस और नो? राइट, अननोइंगली वी आर फॉलिंग इनटू द ट्रैप ऑफ 153. क्लियर? आप देख लीजिए, मैं आई नॉट पुश इट फर्दर, बट हमारे जितने भी मैसेजेस हैं, क्या शायद एक ना एक एंड मोर देन वंस, more than one year, jitne bhi IPC sections likhe hue hain, they are being touched. Yes or no? So up till now, it was slight entertainment of sending forwards and, you know, ridiculing people, sending their videos, right? And memes, etc. But now please read this and decide accordingly, right? Because government is proactive these days, isn't it? And anybody and everybody, Shashi Tharoor, Rajdeep Sardesai, they have been booked under NSA. And see hamara to kya unke samne hai bhai, they are the big top most you know politician and journalists, and when they have been apprehended, so you can think about it, right? Is it making sense now? Right, you can take the screenshot of the slide if you want, right? But things are this way, so what to do? We need to have some media literacy skills, right? Not no explanation of the definition as such, but media literacy is just the skill to gain access. Now access we have, right? We are the world's cheapest data country, right? So we have the access, but we don't have the skill to interpret and critically evaluate the content of the media, right? For us, if anything comes, then it's okay. Okay, we are just forwarding it. So my actually screen is telling me that your internet connection is slow or unstable. Is it, Kamil sir? Is it okay? Am I audible and सही दिख रहा है इसमें? Okay, right. जब भी कुछ हो जाए प्लीज बता दीजिएगा मुझे, I'll change the network. Okay. So media literacy. So Google has launched many products, projects like Factuala is one of them, GNI is one of them, Google News Initiative India, and very soon BBC is also going to launch one, right? Make people media literate and gain access and interpret the masses themselves, right? And see, misinformation and fake news word, if you search on Google. So after 2018, the frequency of the search, it has increased exponentially because the word has been used many where, right? At many places. Before 2018, the frequency is not that much because it was relatively unknown, right? So very quickly now, just going over to the misinformation business. This is not the fake news, actually. I tell you, fake news is a phrase which has been easily recognized by people. That's why you use this. But in the academic environment, please use the misinformation word, right? Because fake, if something is fake, it cannot be news. If it is news, it cannot be fake. Yes or no? So misinformation is the word. So what is misinformation now? If you forward something unintentionally, it becomes misinformation, as simple as that, right? We have already done that so many times, and currently also we are doing. See, I also became victim a few days back when the government supposedly increased the DA of government employees by 21%, right? So it was shared in our media educators group. Amrish sir know that, wo jante hain us baat ko, and then share karne wale bhi kafi credible log the. I was also in a hurry going outside, so I shared that, right? It was found to be a misinformed one, but it's okay. That's okay. No problem. Again, the next one is disinformation. When you spread something intentionally, right? So normally political parties, they are accused of doing disinformation, right? So please don't use these terms interchangeably, misinformation and disinformation. These are all together different one. Third one is also there, right? This is even more sophisticated form of disinformation, right? This is malinformation. When information is genuine, perfectly genuine information, but it is twisted to present the groups which are socially disadvantageous, and the effort is there to harm their image, right? By using the genuine information, but presented in some different way, right? For example, if I open this, so if you receive this image as a WhatsApp forward, what do you believe? Is it a genuine image or it's a fake news, misinformation? What is your common sense? Tell me. What is your judgment on this? This is me sitting before a group of Jain sadhus, right? And I am sitting on a higher position, right? And they are sitting at a lower position. They are learning something from me. So in all probability, it must be a suspicious photograph, right? It's a perfect template for the misinformation, right? Okay, but let me tell you, it is a genuine image, right? I, as a meditation teacher, was invited by the Jain Sthanak here to teach a few techniques of yoga and meditation to Jain sadhus. It was a perfect learning experience. And when I came back, then I touched their feet, and then I came back to my house, right? So this was the whole story. But now if somebody makes this picture viral, right? By mentioning that, okay, now see, Jain Sadhu, they are sitting before a, you know, ordinary person like Umesh Arya, and, you know, inki training shayad pata nahi kaise hui hai, they need to think about that. Are you getting my point, right? Now, information is perfectly okay. It's why the perfect learning experience from both the sides, but it has been presented in a negative way, right? Or a different way, clear? So this is malinformation, M-A-L, right? कितने लोगों के पास कोरोना में वो मैसेज आया है वेयर यू नो ए ग्रुप ऑफ मुस्लिम किड्स दे हैव बीन शोन एज लिकिंग द प्लेट्स राइट लिकिंग द प्लेट्स एंड इन ए दैट्स अ फंक्शन एक्चुअली कम्युनिटी फीस्ट सो व्हाट हैज बीन लेफ्ट ओवर दे आर ईटिंग एंड दे आर यू नो लिकिंग द प्लेट लाइक दिस सो द अंडरलाइंग मैसेज वाज दैट सी दीज पीपल आर ट्राइंग टू स्प्रेड कोरोना इन अवर कंट्री एंड दिस एंड दैट राइट सी द टेक्स्ट ऑफ द मैसेज इज ऑल्सो सस्पिशियस They are trying to spread corona in our country, right? If it is their, not their country, right? Isn't it? So that's a suspicious sentence, but it's okay, right? So there is a particular community in Bohra. Bohra Sampradaya is there. Kamil can tell more about this. I have just limited knowledge about that. But when we verified this, so there's a Bohra community in Muslims where they have been taught not to waste anything, right? Not to waste anything. Now, it's a perfectly pious activity, divine activity, and it has been presented in some wrong way, right? So, that's a kind of malinformation, right? Okay. So, very briefly, there are a few types of the misinformation. Like, first is satire or parody. Like, Times of India becomes Limes of India. So, you also don't care much about the spellings, right? Because we don't have time now. We don't have the time to check critically. So if something like Limes of India, okay, only L is different and L is also in the shape of T, right? Everything is okay. Oh yeah, it is Times of India in the first place, right? But then you get fooled about this, right? So, and Times now becomes Times How. Everything is same. Font is the same, right? And N almost looks like H, right? So, but actually, I mean, these are parody accounts. Everybody knows about this. So that's a good thing. But when you move forward, then the situation becomes something different. Right? So now we are entering into the danger zone where deliberate use of the, you know, wrong information is attributed to the genuine sources. Like BBC ka logo copy kar liya and CNN ka bhi kiya and this news went viral. Then, okay, BJP was the fourth most corrupt largest party in the world, right? So our common sense and the judgment tells that there cannot be any survey like this, clear? And why these, why BBC and CNN will jointly or independently do this nonsense kind of survey, right? So this is a imposter kind of misinformation. It's a fake. And then is false context, meaning thereby the information is perfectly okay. The picture is okay. Now the dead bodies are okay, right? This is genuine information, but they have been presented in a false context, different context, right? So see, they have been shown here as the martyrs of the Pulwama attack, right? But actually it is not, right? They were it was a battalion of CRPF, which were killed by Naxalites in 2010, right? So this is the photograph of the same, but it has been presented in some different way, clear, right? And if you see the background, so this is not looking like Jammu or Kashmir where, you know, greenery is all around, right? So, I mean, this is the false context, right? Then is fabricated, totally fabricated content meaning whereby there is not an even an iota of truth in this, right? Up till now, at least something was truth. The picture was okay. It is genuine, right? BBC logo is genuine, right? CNN is genuine. So up till now, something was genuine. But here, the information is totally fake. First to last, totally fake, fabricated one, right? So, I mean, these are the things. And then misleading content is there, misleading. Now see, you will find so many links on the YouTube where just in order to increase your, attract your eyeballs, this kind of funny visuals, they have been created as a snapshot, as a thumbnail of the video, right? So you will be interested, okay, now how this monkey can, you know, take the stick and hit this panther, right? You will see that. But inside, nothing is there. But the moment you see this video, the user, the creator of the video gets paid by something. Yes or no? That's the main motive, right? And the group of baboons, monkeys, they can't enjoy the line like this. They can't kill. Simply not possible. But it has been shown. Then Rihanna ka Pakistani collection and so many. I mean, that our famous, wo, kya naam hai uska wo? Raat ko 9 baje tez se awaaz mein bolna shuru karta hai. I'm forgetting the name. Republic. Arnab Goswami. Haan. Republic India pe, right? Rihanna ka Pakistani collection. Karara jawab, antrik maamlo mein dakhal kyun? I mean, ye, this is nonsense, right? Media is being judged now. It is performing the duty of a judge, which is the simply the case of the misleading the content, right? So, I mean, these are the types of misinformation. Then the question comes ki why people, create and spread misinformation, right? First is the act of poor journalism, right? Let me tell you, this is the last slide. After this, we will start the real-time training of that. So poor journalism, right? Because Rajdeep Sir, this I also declared Pranab Mukherjee that just 1 week before, right? The actual death. So it was just a case of poor journalism, poor judgment. That's all, right? So sometimes it can create the fake news. To parody somebody, that's also one of the reason. To prove oneself or to punk somebody, so that's one of the reason. Then people have passion for, spreading misinformation. Some people are really, they are really good at, creating and spreading misinformation. Then is partisanship, that they are deliberately biased towards some kind of agenda. That's why they create the fake news. Then people do it for profit. This is the main reason, right? Because profit, drives every network, every information, there is some kind of angle of profit behind that. So then political influence is there during the time of elections, misinformation increases. Then is propaganda. Now propaganda is deliberate, right? Against some particular company, particular individual, group of individual institutions or the political parties, right? So these are the broad reasons. Of course, there can be many more. What to do then? So what we'll do is, okay, just before going to the training part, this is the image, right? So aapka kya kehna hai is image ke bare mein? Maybe like that, okay, it has been now 30 minutes, so I should present something which interests you, yes or no? And since most of the people are young here, so they need this kind of break in between. Yeah. Can you tell me what is this? Yash, Yashaswika. Okay. It came during COVID. Yes. But this was good, na? Such kind of activity should be there. People are making love. What's the problem with this? Okay. So this is the fact actually, right? The husband was dying, so the lady tried to help him by giving the oxygen through her mouth because the oxygen was not available outside, right? So the actual image is this, right? But it will be presented to you in this form in the times to come, right? Look, this was happening before this college, and this, that college, and this area is so, and moral trepidation is there, like all these kind of things. Could you get my point? Yes. Okay. Why do we do this? Now, this is the slide which tells us that we should understand how do we understand, right? We must understand how do we make, how do we think something? Okay. For example, if I present some kind of evidence to you, right? Perfect facts and evidences. Would you believe those evidences? No, you will not believe, because you will believe only the part of the evidence which is telling with your belief system, your thinking system. Yes or no? Do you agree with this or not? You can write either yes or no in the chat. Iska matlab ye hai ki फैक्ट्स और एविडेंसेस की कोई वैल्यू नहीं है। हाँ, जो हमें सही लगेगा हम तो उस पर विश्वास करेंगे। यस, नाउ दिस इज द बिगेस्ट फॉली विच पीपल यू नो दे कमिट, बिकॉज दे आर द थिंकिंग कॉन्शियस, राइट? वो अपनी थिंकिंग से उन चीजों को देखते हैं कि अगर उनको ठीक लगा देन वो एक्सेप्ट करते हैं, और अगर उनको ठीक नहीं लगा तो वो इग्नोर करते हैं फैक्ट्स और एविडेंस चाहे कुछ भी हो। नाउ दिस इज अगेन ए परफेक्ट टेम्पलेट फॉर द फेक न्यूज पीपल टू मेक यू बिलीव समथिंग, राइट? या यू गॉट माई पॉइंट ऑर नॉट? बिकॉज अनलेस इट टचेज यूर बिलीफ, राइट? एंड अवर बिलीव आर क्या? हिंदू मुस्लिम एंड राम मंदिर, दिस दैट, दिस आर अवर परफेक्ट यू नो ideas of our population. So they have their beliefs. So whatever is presented in a in their telling with their belief system, they will immediately accept that, right? Okay, what to do then? We have to verify. Kis cheez ko verify karenge? Text, images and videos, right? Got my point? Huh? So from now onwards it will be a practical class. Huh? I would like you to please switch on the videos once, right? And then I'll share my screen again. Okay, because this is a training part now, and training part is something which is, you know, two way. Huh? Okay. पता नहीं यहाँ guests को follow नहीं करते क्या लोग? ऐसा होता है क्या? सुष्मिता मैम, भाई हमारे तो कोई भी आता है बाहर से गेस्ट, तो वो बोल देता है कि वीडियो ऑन करो, तो सारे के सारे बच्चे वीडियो ऑन कर लेते हैं, राइट? मुझे पता नहीं, आई डोंट नो यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है। इट्स ओके, कोई बात नहीं, इट्स ओके, लेट देम रिलैक्स। हाँ, रिफ्लेक्सोलॉजी वाला लेक्चर को ज्यादा ध्यान से सुन लिया उन्होंने। हाँ, दैट वी शुड रिलैक्स एंड वी शुड यू नो कीप अवर, वी शुड स्माइल, इट्स ओके, कोई बात नहीं, राइट? सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द ट्रेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ इट नाउ। सो आई विल टेक टू थ्री एग्जांपल्स। फर्स्ट आई विल टेक टेक्स्ट, देन इमेज, देन वीडियो, राइट? बिकॉज दीज आर द थ्री फॉर्मेट्स इन विच द मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन कम्स टू यू। कैन यू टेल मी विच इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर फॉर्मेट इन दिस? विच इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर फॉर्मेट आउट ऑफ टेक्स्ट, वीडियो एंड इमेजेस in which the misinformation comes to you?
Video.
Video, very good. Video. Okay. And then second, images. Images, okay, very good. Followed by images, right? So, well, the international experience in research tells that not only international but Indian also, research was conducted by Fakshala and they came out with the finding that image is the first favorite format, because you don't need to write much under the image. Jaise maine abhi image dikhaya tha, that was self-explanatory, isn't it? Right? So image is the first, video is the second, and text comes last, right? So that's international behavior of spreading the misinformation. So we'll take it one by one. First is text, right? So let me share my screen again. So this simple reliability check, it is for all the three formats, right? So whenever you receive any information, ask it three questions. First is who is behind the information? Who must have sent it? If you are receiving it about a particular religion, right? Then you can very well make out who is behind the information. Means the opposite people, yes or no? The rival religious people, isn't it? Okay, question number second, what is the evidence? What is the evidence of the things which have been mentioned in the message, right? For example, I don't know whether the message has come to you or not, but I used to receive the message that, okay, after this COVID second wave, there will be a civil war in this country, right? And Muslim majority will have an upper hand. So all of you are requested to kindly keep some firearms in the house and start, preparing for the emergency. There can be anything. This was the message. मेरे पास बहुत बार आया और मेरे colleagues के बाद काफी बार आया. Okay. चलिए हम इसको 2 मिनट के लिए believe कर लेते हैं. भाई message है तो उसको believe कर लेते हैं. लेकिन उससे तीन क्वेश्चन पूछे, जैसे मैंने बताया हु इज बिहाइंड द इन्फॉर्मेशन, राइट? इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस यू विल नॉट फाइंड आउट बिकॉज इट इज अ फॉरवर्ड, राइट? फॉरवर्ड 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 फिनिश, यू कांट आइडेंटिफाई द सोर्स. एंड वुड यू बिलीव एनी इन्फॉर्मेशन हुज सोर्स इज नॉट आइडेंटिफाइड? नो, नॉट एट ऑल. सो द मैसेज वॉज डाउटफुल, राइट? देन सेकेंड इज ओके फाइन, वट इज द एविडेंस ऑफ द कंटेंट? उन्होंने ये लिखा हुआ है कि देर विल बी सिविल वॉर दिस कंट्री एंड पार्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी विल हैव एन अपर हैंड. वट इज द एविडेंस ऑफ इट? आई डोंट सी एनी. तो इट विल फेल ऑन दिस काउंट ऑल्सो. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, वट डू अदर सोर्सेज से? यू ट्राई टू सर्च इंटरनेट और अदर इंफॉर्मेशन आउट देयर इन द मीडिया. आई मीन देर इज नो इन्फॉर्मेशन लाइक दिस. Nobody is saying anything about this. Any credible information is not there. So how do we believe? So that message fails on all these counts, right? The message was fake. Clear? Now, see. So this was a text message received on WhatsApp. आप इसको ध्यान से पढ़िए. There are two methods of verifying. First is the organic method. You don't need any technology for that, right? You just read the message and you will come to know that this is fake. And second is with the help of the tools, right? You can find out that, okay, is this fake. So let's go to the first method. First is this message, came on 23rd March onwards. Or 22 March ko thali button peete the humne jo doctors ke liye. So 23rd March ko viral hua that, okay? Jo clapping hua tha, uski wajah se there is a vibration in the atmosphere, and those vibrations, they have been detected by the NASA COVID satellite, right? NASA SD-13 satellite, sorry. And after that, the COVID cases, they have come down in India, right? Now, this is a very good message, na? Huh? Aapka believe karne ka man karta hai, na? Because the message is so emotive, so emotive, right? It touches your emotions, isn't it? Let me tell you one thing here, that the fake news or the misinformation has to have this quality of touching your extreme emotions, right? Otherwise, it will fail. Clear? So, this message was forwarded by Amitabh Bachchan and Sonu Nigam, right? Such was the appeal of this message. So, people also forwarded. So, I mean, then they had to apologize actually. So, let's verify this message through organic method. Now, see, first clue is forwarded. This is a forward message, right? We don't believe forward, simply. Then you read the message throughout. If you are looking at some kind of highlighted messages, NASA, it has been put in caps and, bold and SD-13 bold, then big thanks to everyone for making this a success. Why? It is just like crime, right? The message is seeking attention. Jab agar message aapka genuine hai, toh itna shringar karne ki usko kya zarurat hai, isn't it? So, आप देखिए, there are many, sign of exclamations, interrogations, right? So, these are a very few, these are the templates actually to attract the people's attention, isn't it? And in the last, if you come proud to be an Indian and Jai Hind, Mera Bharat Mahan, this, that, okay, Bharat Mahan hai. But ye message mein use karte to fake template ka ek jabardast part hai wo. Aap samajh jayega ki message pakka fake hai. And in many cases, you will see forward this message to so many people. Yes or no? Forward this message ताकि कोई benefit होने से रहना जाए. ये perfect misinformation का एक क्या है? Example है. आप समझे मेरी बात को? हाँ? Right? Am I audible?
Yes. Okay.
So this was the organic part of the method. You read that if it is against a particular religion, particular party, person, institution, etc., it is doubtful one, right? If it is forward, second doubt, right? Third, if a few words are highlighted, doubtful. Or last mein agar ye hai ki forwarded to so many people, big thanks to everyone, ye pakka fake hai abhi, right? So over a period of time, we know that this is fake, but let's use the technology to debunk this. Right? Should we do this? Huh? Should we go to the technology? Okay. So we'll open Google for that. And this is Google. Okay. Now, the most common method of debunking, as I told you, that I'll share one method which is singularly applicable on all the three formats, right? Through that method, you can verify all the three formats at one go, right? So the method is that you need to extract 5 to 6 keywords out of the masses. 5 to 6 keywords, for example, NASA, COVID, clapping, vibrations, okay, satellite. These are the keywords now, main keywords, right? Okay. If you enter in Google and 44 results are there now. Fact check. People have already fact checked it for you. It is fake message. Clear? Outlook India has done that. News 18, Deccan Chronicle, so many. HA Asia. Now this was 50 fake frequently forwarded messages as far as COVID-19 is concerned. One additional information. What we did? Nothing. We just coined these keywords, right? And we entered in Google in a random way, random manner, and entered, and then we got the result. Because the moment a message is made viral, so the army of the fact checker gets behind that message, right? It debunks that message, puts the same on their website, and whenever you enter into Google, it searches that. Got my point? Yeah. Okay. But as far as Google is concerned, it can show the, wrong information also, because it works on the similarity index. Do you know this? Google works on the similarity index. It doesn't know whether the results are genuine or fake. It is finding these words in the web pages, and jahan bhi usko mil rahe hai, wo aapke samne leke aa raha hai, right? Now, it is our responsibility now to check the websites, whether they are credible or not, right? So there is one more website. It is a fact-checking search engine developed by me, especially for this. So you can find it on factchecking.in. This also works on the Google principle, right? But in a slightly different way, right? You can enter the keywords, random keywords. This way also it will work. Another method is that you can enter in a form of sentence. For example, clapping vibrations message on COVID, right? By NASA. Okay. Ye dekhiye, India Today. There is only one. अब इसको आप अगर इसका पोजीशन चेंज कर दोगे वर्ड्स की तो 3-4 मैसेज मिल जाएंगे. नाउ सी व्हाई ओनली वन रिजल्ट और टू रिजल्ट, ओनली 4 रिजल्ट्स, नॉट 45 और 400 लाइक गूगल. बिकॉज नाउ माई सर्च इंजन सर्चेस ओनली इंडियाज टॉप 20 फैक्ट चेकिंग वेबसाइट्स. क्लियर? ओनली इंडियाज 20 टॉप चेकिंग वेबसाइट्स, एंड इट प्रेजेंट्स द रिजल्ट बिफोर यू. सो द रिजल्ट्स दे हैव टू बी क्रेडिबल. Whatever appears here in the form of result, please accept that, because that is coming from the top fact checking websites, not the kind of random blogs or fake news websites. No, nothing. Could you get my point? Right? So this is free. You can use that. And as far as Google is concerned, so they also have got, one very good search engine made recently. Let me share screen and tell. Yeah, Google Fact Check Explorer, right? So it is not that much popular for strange reasons. I don't know why. But if you enter Google Fact Check Explorer in Google itself, then the first link will come, and this will be the interface. Now, if you enter something here, right, then all the world's fact check stories, they will appear. Isn't it? And most probably your message will definitely be there. Clear? So now the area has been widened by Google, isn't it? But in some cases I have seen that this also fails, right? Because it requires you to search in a particular manner, right? But that normal Google and fact checking dot in my search engine, it never fails, right? You just change the arrangement and you will get the definite results. So these two sites you can remember. I have already told you this, factchecking.in, MyOne, and Google Fact Check Tools. This is sufficient, right? It is sufficient for every kind of format, be it image, be it video or text. Clear? What my point? Let's come to now the image checking. Image, okay. So see, somebody sent me the image and he said, okay, see, I have opened a new institution and it's a very good, building is so good. So ask your students to take admissions. Okay, it's an ABC university, right? ABC Institute. Should I show you that? Huh? तो किसी ने मुझे ये भेजा था, देखो हमने कितना बढ़िया एबीसी इंस्टीट्यूट बनाया है, आप अपने बच्चों को बोलो एडमिशन लो इसमें, राइट? आपको पता चला कौन सा इंस्टीट्यूट है देख के ये? नहीं पता चला? ओके, लेट अस सी, इसको कंफर्म करते हैं हम. वी विल नॉट बिलीव कि भाई ये सच है, हम इसको क्या करेंगे, वेरीफाई करेंगे कि ये वाकई में है या ऐसे इन्होंने बना के होंगे. तो द वेरी इजी मेथड इज ओपन अगेन गूगल इमेजेस. देयर आर गूगल इमेजेस. ओके, या इमेजेस डॉट गूगल डॉट कॉम, इट्स अ वेरी कॉमन वेबसाइट. प्रेस ऑन दिस कैमरा, अपलोड दैट इमेज हियर, राइट? एंड आई एम अपलोडिंग दैट. It's a ABC University, right? And it is uploading that image here. And once the uploading is done, so the results will be there for you. See, it will try to search the similar images, right? It also works on the similarity index, isn't it? So it is telling me that it is BME College. Oh, is it? Kamil, Amrish sir, this is a question for you now. Is it a DME college? I did not write that here. Na? So I did not write this. This is auto guess by Google. Right? I just entered this screenshot, which was sent to me by my friend. See, I have opened up this and please take admission into that. Okay. I need to verify ki wahi school hai aur kahin ka hai. So I upload in Google. Google is telling me something different. Ye bola hai, best law college in Delhi NCR. BGMC ka naam bhi hai. और इट विल सर्च सिमिलर इमेजेस. नाउ सिमिलर इमेजेस आर लाइक दिस. आप देखिए ये फर्स्ट वाली इमेज बिल्कुल सिमिलर लग रही है, यस और नो? अगेन सिमिलरिटी इंडेक्स. ओके, अगर इसमें भी बात ना बने एंड इफ द गूगल इज यू नो गैसिंग दिस वन ऑल्सो इनकरेक्टली, ऐसा हो सकता है, राइट? बिकॉज इफ यू यू नो टेक द सेम इमेज बिल्डिंग डीएमई, राइट? एंड इफ यू इन द बैकग्राउंड यू शो यू नो स्काई in a wide proportion, right? So Google will say, Google will match it with the sky kind of images, right? So that can be wrong. DME college, this auto guess may be wrong. Fortunately, in this case, it is right because it's an old image. So indexing has been done properly. That's okay. But this is also not sure, right? So go to the images, right? Fortunately, there is one image which is exactly similar, right? If it is not, just in order to cross check, go to this first link. See, IP University College DME Noida goes beyond the classroom. Now Times of India ki website pe ye image hai and aap isko click kare, ye to bata rahi hai ki hamari DME ka hai, ye to aur bhi kafi images. Now it is established ki wo fraud thi jo unhone bheja, wo misinformation tha mere paas, ye asli photo hai aur ye it belongs to DME, not that ABC University. You got my point? Clear? Okay. Now see, this was one when the image was there with you and you uploaded, right? So if the image is already there on some fraud website or some, you know, mischievous school who is saying that, okay, this is our building and they are showing it, right? What to do? Then we have to right click on that and then there will be an auto link. Auto option that search Google with this image, right? So again, same kind of result would come, right? So that process of uploading is bypassed. Are you getting my point, right? So recently I was taking the similar workshop for teachers in a one of the very prominent school in Haryana. I will not name. So when I downloaded some similar image from their website, right? just to show them, I mean, the shocker like this. So when I searched the internet, so the similar image was used by at least four other schools. Some school in Agra, some school in Noida, and library, because they are standard images, right? Isn't it? So everybody puts that. Now it's a matter of concern and investigation. उन्होंने कहां से लिया है, किसका कहां पे सबसे पहले अपलोड हुआ है, ताकि उसको ऑनर माना जा सके, वो दूसरी बात है. बट द टीचर्स आर शॉक्ड टू सी दिस, राइट, दैट मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इज प्रेजेंट इन देयर वेबसाइट ऑल्सो, राइट. सो दिस वाज इमेज, क्लियर, आई एम गेटिंग माय पॉइंट. हाँ, दिस इज इमेज वेरिफिकेशन डन, सिंपल, इससे अलावा कुछ नहीं है इसमें. वीडियो वेरिफिकेशन पे आए, हाँ.
Yes.
और अगर अच्छा, चलिए मैंने आपको बताया था एक बार कि आई विल टेल यू ए मेथड थ्रू विच यू कैन वेरीफाई ऑल द थ्री फॉर्मेट्स, राइट. ओके, सो लेट मी शेयर दैट मेथड. हाँ, सो द मेथड इज अगेन वेरी सिंपल. शेयर दिस. सो दिस वाज द ट्वीट बाय शशि थरूर, हु सेड, सी नेहरू एंड इंदिरा गांधी इन यूएस इन 1954, मोदी जी आजकल घूम रहे हैं, कितना पैसा खर्च करते हैं पब्लिसिटी पे, और हमारे कांग्रेस के लीडर्स गए थे यूएस में 1954 में, एंड देयर वाज नो मनी स्पेंड, और फिर भी कितना लोग उनको देखने को आए, राइट. ओके, अब ये इमेज आया था ट्वीट के द्वारा. सो शशि थरूर, यू नो, वेरी बिग पर्सनैलिटी, राइट, यूनाइटेड नेशंस के वो आई थिंक डिप्टी डायरेक्टर जनरल रह चुके हैं वो, और फेमस पॉलिटिशियन हैं शशि थरूर, तो उनकी बात तो माननी पड़ेगी. बट जब इसको हमने क्या किया, चेक किया, तो इट वाज फाउंड टू बी नॉट फेक बट आउट ऑफ द कंटेक्स्ट, राइट, मीनिंग थेरबाय इट वाज इन रशिया नॉट यूएस. रेस्ट एवरीथिंग वाज ओके, बट इट वाज रशिया एक्चुअली, राइट, नॉट यूएस, राइट. ओके, सो इफ दिस ट्वीट कम्स टू यू, राइट, हाउ वुड यू वेरीफाई ऑर्गेनिकली, राइट. The one thing is that you upload it on Google. I just told you, right, you download this or click on the right side of it, and then it will be uploaded on Google Images. Then you see the results. But I told you, now there is a simple method. You extract another 5 to 6 keywords out of this, right? Same which you did in the text, right? Fortunately, there is a text to it now, isn't it? वो अपने आप text में उन्होंने लिखा हुआ है, तो इसमें से keyword आपको मिल गया अभी, और इसको हम check करते हैं, right? हम जाते हैं अभी हमारे गूगल को ओपन करते हैं. ओके, नाउ व्हाट आर द कीवर्ड्स, शशि थरूर, राइट, गांधी, नेहरू यूएस 1954, राइट. ओके, द मोमेंट यू क्लिक दिस, देर आर मेनी रिजल्ट्स, फेक अलर्ट, शशि थरूर ट्वीट्स फोटो फ्रॉम नेहरू, इट वाज इन द रशिया एक्चुअली, आपको मिल जाएगा इसमें. देखिए कितने सारे लोगों ने ऑलरेडी चेक किया हुआ है इसको, isn't it? Again, the keyword method is the same. Apply this. If the text is not available below the image, then extract a few keywords from the photograph, right? From your judgment, isn't it? Then see the results. So there are high chances that you will find many fact checkers who have already debunked this. For more information, you go to images. You will find these images, right? And people have flagged this, that is fake. Because now the center, the concern, the object of concern was the picture, right? So it is advisable to go to images, isn't it? And then people have mentioned it, fact checked it, and told you the truth, that it is fake. You got my point, huh? Just simple, you know, juggling of the tools, nothing else. As far as image is concerned, this is it. Nothing beyond this, right? So we come to the video verification now, right? Video verification is very, very simple. Huh? Even more simple than this. Okay. Are you listening now? Huh? अगर आप वीडियो स्विच ऑन नहीं कर सकते तो आप चैट में तो लिख ही सकते हैं, राइट, चैट बॉक्स में तो लिख ही सकते हैं. अगर चैट में भी आपने नहीं लिखा, फिर मीटिंग को मैं अभी छोड़ रहा हूं तुरंत, सभी लोग सुन रहे हैं. चैट पे भी अगर कोई लिखेगा तो फिर Yes, sir, we are with you. Okay. Thank you. जागिए प्लीज, थोड़ी देर में आप सो जाइएगा, 30 मिनट्स के बाद आपको मैं 30 नहीं ओनली 10 मिनट्स सॉरी 10 और 15 मिनट्स हैं क्वेश्चन आंसर मिला।
कैमरा ऑन करने में क्या प्रॉब्लम होती है? आई डोंट नो।
कोई बात नहीं, बच्चे हैं, वी आर लिसनिंग टू यू सर, थैंक यू सो मच मोहित, वेरी गुड, आई एम मोबिलाइज्ड।
बच्चे बड़े सब हैं?
नहीं, अच्छे बच्चे हैं, ये आप इनको कुछ मत कहिए, हां ये बहुत अच्छे हैं, वेरी गुड।
तो हम लोगों की तरह
लर्निंग मेथड
ही लेते हैं ना सब, अभी आराम से बैठे होंगे।
हाँ, एक्चुअली वो क्या है, फटीग है, ये 1.5 साल का फटीग हम समझ सकते हैं, राइट, इसलिए मैं कभी अब 1 मिनट से ज्यादा जोर नहीं देता, बट हाँ ये मैं डेफिनेटली वुड लाइक टू एंश्योर कि आप लोग कम से कम सुन रहे हैं इस चीज को, दैट सफिशिएंट फॉर मी। हाँ, तो चैट पे लिखने से बात बन जाएगा। अभी हम बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट करने जा रहे हैं, वो लास्ट है इसका, 5 मिनट से ज्यादा इसमें नहीं लगेगा, दैट इज नाउ आपका वीडियो वेरिफिकेशन, राइट। सो देर आर टू वेज, फर्स्ट इज वीडियो आपके व्हाट्सएप पे आ गया, उसको डाउनलोड कीजिए अपने लैपटॉप पे, राइट, एक तरीका ये हो गया। इन सेकेंड केस द वीडियो लिंक इज सेंड टू यू, दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन यूट्यूब, विमियो, फेसबुक, ट्विटर एटसेट्रा, राइट, ऑलरेडी ऑनलाइन। इन बोथ द केसेज टूल इज वेरी सिंपल, हाँ आई थिंक लास्ट टाइम ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड, इट इज InVid, right? InVid extension बोल के एक आप डाउनलोड कर लीजिएगा, this is Chrome extension, अब Firefox पे भी शायद आता है। InVid माने inside video, right? Simple. आप इसको इंस्टॉल कर लीजिए और जब ये यहाँ पे आ जाएगा क्रोम पे, then it will be available like this, right? यहाँ पे open InVid, it will open like this, और key frame में it will tell you two options. Insert the video link, I told you, if it is already in the YouTube, right? Right here, the link. If it is on desktop, upload that file from local file here, right? In all the probabilities, it will, you know, it will upload it and split the video in different keyframes, right? You know, the video is composed of many still images. How many of you know that? कितने लोग जानते हैं इसको? वीडियो जो होता है वो काफी स्टिल इमेजेस से मिलकर बना होता है। सो ये InVid extension कुछ नहीं करेगा, ये सिर्फ वो पिक्चर्स को अलग अलग कर देगा, सो दैट यू कैन हैव ए फेयर आइडिया। लेट मी सी, अगर मेरे पास कोई वीडियो अगर पड़ा हो तो सो दैट मैं आपको शेयर करके इसको बता सकूं। जस्ट ए मिनट, एक सेकेंड दीजिए मुझे। रफाल, ये लास्ट टाइम भी शायद मैंने बताया था। ओके, सो मैं अभी इसको पेस्ट कर रहा हूं अपने इस पे, एंड एक बार मैं ओपन कर देता हूं। यस, अभी विल गो टू डेस्कटॉप, यहां पे हमें एक वीडियो मिलेगा रफाल के नाम से, रफाल जेट वीडियो। ओके, सो सबमिट जो मैंने किया तो इट इज सबमिटिंग दैट, इट इज अपलोडिंग टू इट्स पेरेंट सर्वर। तो जब ये अपलोड कर चुका होगा, सो व्हाट इट विल डज, वो आपके सामने अभी उस वीडियो के अलग अलग स्क्रीनशॉट्स अवेलेबल आपके सामने होंगे, राइट, फ्रेगमेंट्स में अभी काम कर रहा है, एंड जस्ट अबाउट टू ओपन आई थिंक। ओ यस, आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? हाँ, क्या ये देखिए, सारी मूवमेंट्स का इसने क्या किया, स्क्रीनशॉट लेके उसको तोड़ दिया अलग से। आप देखिए ध्यान से, नाउ वन इमेज, अभी इमेज बन गया, वीडियो वेरिफिकेशन नहीं रहा, राइट, और इमेज वेरिफिकेशन कैसे करना है आपको मैंने बताया था। हाँ, आप क्या करें, जब आपके InVid इंस्टॉल होता है तो ये एक्सटेंशन फेक न्यूज डिबंकर बाय InVid वी वेरीफाई, ये ऑटोमेटिकली इंस्टॉल हो जाता है उस पर, राइट। आप इस पे जाइए, किसी भी एक इमेज पे क्लिक कर दीजिए और यहां पे जाइए इमेज रिवर्स सर्च गूगल, राइट, गूगल से कीजिए, इससे बात नहीं बनती, इंडेक्स पे आ जाइए नीचे, मैं गूगल पे करता हूं पहले, राइट। नाउ सी, अभी मैं क्या कर रहा हूं, वीडियो वेरिफिकेशन कर रहा हूं, राइट, थ्रू इमेजेस, कुड यू गेट माय पॉइंट? आई हैव ब्रोकन दैट वीडियो इनटू इमेजेस और इमेज वेरिफिकेशन कर रहा हूं मैं। नाउ सी, आई वाज टेलिंग यू दिस, गूगल will guess it incorrectly if the background is not that which is your interest, isn't it? Because अभी आप क्या है, रफाल का वीडियो आया था, रफाल वो एक्रोबैटिक्स में दिखाते हुए कि देखो कितना अच्छा है रफाल, तो उसमें ये स्काई वाला पोर्शन आया हुआ है. गूगल ने सोचा ये डोमिनेंट पोर्शन है, तो इट मीन्स हम स्काई की इमेजेस देखना चाहते हैं, तो ये सिमिलर इमेजेस हमें ये दिखा रहा है जिसमें स्काई डोमिनेंट है या ग्रासलैंड डोमिनेंट है, और खुद बोल रहा है वो ग्रासलैंड है ये. अब हमने तो नहीं बोला इसको ग्रासलैंड है, ये ऑटो गेस कर रहा है मशीन लर्निंग से, जो कि गलत है. ओके राइट, ये वीडियो एक्चुअली रफाल का बोल के आया था कि देखिए रफाल कितना अच्छा है, कितनी अच्छी एक्रोबैटिक्स करता है वो सब ऐसा करके, और उसको हमने डिबंक अभी करना है. लेकिन बात नहीं बन रही, आप देखिए ये कुछ बात बता नहीं रहा है हमें. नीचे वाले वीडियो बोल रहे हैं कि हाँ ये आर्मी का बहुत अच्छा वो है, शेयर चैट है, शेयर चैट तो सोशल मीडिया है, वहां तो मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन चलता ही रहता है. नाउ समबडी सेइंग न्यूजीलैंड में आतंकवादी हमला, टेररिस्ट अटैक इन न्यूजीलैंड, व्हाट अ नॉनसेंस. पीएम मोदी का मिशन शक्ति, नाउ ये सारे लिंक्स दे आर नॉट टू बी बिलीव, राइट. व्हाट टू डू देन, हमारा ये काम नहीं कर रहा, आप क्या कीजिए, ये ग्रासलैंड वाले इसको डिलीट कर दीजिए, राइट. एंड यहाँ पे अपना कोई कीवर्ड डालिए, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं लिखता हूँ ये वीडियो मेरे पास रफाल बोल के आया था, राइट, रफाल फेक वीडियो, आई डाउट दैट दिस इज ए फेक वीडियो, राइट. सो आई हैव टोल्ड गूगल सर्च दिस वे, यूज द इमेज एंड सर्च थ्रू दिस कीवर्ड. सो अब आप देखिए क्या करता है ये, ऑलरेडी फैक्ट चेक, यस और नो, अब रिजल्ट सही दिखाया इसने, 5 के वायरल वीडियो क्लेमिंग टू बी रफाल इज एक्चुअली टर्बाइन जेट. आप मेरी बात को समझे, सुष्मिता मैम इज इट ओके, मैं कन्वे कर पाया इसको जो आपको, इन केस ऑफ वीडियो, राइट, आप क्या करें उसको, इनविड में जाएं, इमेजेस बन जाएंगी, इमेज में राइट क्लिक करें, इमेज वेरिफिकेशन हो जाएगा, ज्यादातर केस में पता चली जाएगा, इस केस में पता नहीं चल रहा है तो आप यहाँ पे अपना कीवर्ड को डाल दें जो भी आप सस्पेक्ट कर रहे हैं. दूसरा तरीका क्या है, आप गूगल खोल लें, कुछ मत करें, नथिंग, राइट. सो रफाल फेक वीडियो, सिर्फ इतना डाल दें ओनली. अब मैं इमेज वगैरह कहीं नहीं ले रहा हूं, उसमें मेरे पास मैसेज आया, देयर वाज अ वीडियो एंड इट वाज मेंशन इन द टेक्स्ट, सी व्हाट अ गुड रफाल इट इज एंड कांग्रेस पीपल दे आर एंटी नेशनल, दे आर स्टॉलिंग द डील एंड ऑल काइंड ऑफ दैट. सो व्हाट आर द कीवर्ड्स नाउ, रफाल वीडियो इज देयर, आई सस्पेक्ट दैट इट इज फेक. इतना मैं करते ही अगर लिखता हूं ना, सो यू विल हैव दिस लिंक, पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी फैक्ट चेक इट फॉर यू, जस्ट 3 simple words, जस्ट ओनली 3. You can, you know, put additional words, keywords, no problem in that, right? Again, 75, same people have done it for you. So, this is it. Text, images and videos, just point 5 to 6 words, that's all. इससे ज़्यादा ध्यान रखने की ज़रूरत नहीं है आपको, ठीक है? The takeaway is extract 5 or 6 keywords out of every information and search them on Google.
Yes.
And then see the information clearly, see the results clearly, you will find your way. Thank you so much. That's it.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving us insights on how to debunk this misinformation that is around us. And you always make things so easy for us to understand, sir. And now we have so many questions that I would like to take them very quickly because we have a session at 11:30 also. So one of the students is asking, sir, we can easily have sessions like this for students, academicians, and for privileged class. We can talk about different laws and make them aware about the things. But question here is how to sensitize grassroots public and people who do not understand media like we do. And he is referring to the class who is not literate about media. So what is your...
Very good. So see, there is a Factshala project from Google and I have shared the website and we are the trainer of Factshala also. So what we do is that we go to villages, we go to the schools, and you know, NGOs, clubs, etc. So many. I mean, the list is endless, right? These are all the general public, right? These are not the high class people, and the content is also regional in the Odia language, you know, Kannada, Tamil, etc., Punjabi, whatever, Hindi, English. So people go to the villages and they take the workshop there. So this is the project which was launched in, I think, in September 2020. And again, for your kind information, now BBC is also coming up with a similar project. And I sent you the link about the sign up part of it. So they are going to prepare the trainers, and they will educate the school children, right? Only school children, because they are the formative citizens, right? And you know, at this stage, their grasping power is very high. Whatever the teacher tells, they will accept it as the Brahm Vakya, right? So this is the target. So yeah, these are the common people. They are not from the privileged class. So projects aise ho rahe hain abhi. आप देखते जाइए अभी शिक्षाला में बहुत सारी ट्रेनिंग्स हो चुके हैं. आई थिंक मोर देन 20,000 पीपल दे हैव बीन ट्रेन्ड इन द लास्ट 7 or 8 months, राइट, सिंस सितंबर 2020.
अभी प्रोफेसर उमेश आर्य, हम लोगों ने भी किया था, जैसे डीएमई इन कोलैबोरेशन विद एडामास यूनिवर्सिटी, वी लॉन्च्ड अ मीडिया लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम. So we did this 12-day this media literacy course for the students of Mayuri School and Delhi World Public School.
Uh-huh.
So these kind of efforts, I mean, continuous efforts are made, then definitely we can reach out to more and more number of people.
Uh-huh. Yes, you are right actually. And the question was about the unprivileged section more. So जैसे मैंने बताया, फैक्शला इज स्पेशली फॉर देम, राइट? तो इवन पीपल हैव आवर ट्रेनर्स, दे हैव कंडक्टेड ट्रेनिंग सेशन फॉर द सेक्स वर्कर्स आल्सो, राइट, इन कोलकाता, इन दिल्ली. सो आई मीन, व्हाट टू टॉक अबाउट अदर मिडिल सेक्शंस, राइट? सो वी हैव गोन टू द रियली ग्रासरूट लेवल्स, राइट? सो एफर्ट्स हो रहे हैं अभी.
One important question I have received, sir, in context with the futuristic technology, or what we can say that changing technology. One of the students from DME Media School is asking, there have been discussions of blockchain technology getting rid of fake news concept in near future. How do you see that, and how effective it would be? If you could tell us more about how blockchain technology works.
Yes, see, I'm not from a technical background, but जितना भी मैं blockchain के बारे में जानता हूँ, जो भी technology secure use होती है ना, तो financial markets में पहले होता है, right? बिकॉज ये फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजेक्शन में वो कई बार क्लोनिंग हो जाती है, इस करके पीपल लूज लॉट ऑफ मनी, राइट? सो दैट इज नथिंग बट ए सिक्योर फॉर्म ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन, राइट? सिक्योर फॉर्म ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन पीसेज, बी इट द फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजेक्शन, बी इट सम काइंड ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल ट्रांजेक्शन, बी इट लाइक यू नो इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट टू यू, राइट? फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट टू यू, इजंट इट? एंड जो भी, जैसे आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस क्या करते हैं वो लोग, दे यू नो प्रोसेस द इंफॉर्मेशन एज पर द पार्टिकुलर टेम्पलेट, राइट? जो भी उस टेम्पलेट के उसमें आता है, देन इट बिकम फिक्स, राइट? सो इट इज अबाउट द सिक्योरिंग ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी. आई मीन, आई एम नॉट वेरी श्योर दैट आई हैव आंसर्ड दिस क्वेश्चन राइट, बट अभी फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजेक्शन में यूज हो रहे हैं, लेट्स सी आगे कितना यूज होता है इसमें.
Used in cryptocurrency also, I read it somewhere.
Ah.
So my next question to you is, I have received this question from Ms. Yashashrika Yadav. She is a research scholar at JNU and a former assistant professor at DME Media School. She is asking that the government has issued the new IT guidelines about the end-to-end encryption that can be compromised to find out the originator of the message. Do you think that this will help in curbing the fake news? What are your views on it, sir?
Yes and no, right? Both. Because yes, because the fake news is the result of the forward this phenomena, right? And the actual resource is never traced up. So as far as the fake news is concerned, the origin is concerned, yeah, you can really go to the IT cells, I mean the real source, and they can be taken to task. But the other side of it, that any governments any kind of government, they first try to, you know, push through these kind of IT rules for the seemingly benefit of the public, right? But ultimately they have their own hidden agenda, right? So they will then identify the problematic elements which are anti-establishment, right? As you know, if you watch NDTV, then there are so many cases of people put behind the bars just because of the film on the flimsy grounds, right? Isn't it? Other channels won't show it, and no, there will not be any whisper even in the dominant media. They will keep on crying, they will keep on pushing in the loud voice, right? Irrelevant issues. But actual part is that the second part is that government will pinpoint and the dissidents, right? And currently, abhi jo aap dekhiye reporting agar padhenge aapko pata chal jayega ki attorney general is giving such bizarre kind of arguments in the Supreme Court, right? The some particular people should be handcuffed because they can run away. Hurry. I mean, these are nonsense kind of things. So going by these news, we can safely infer that government may do this, right? So there are both the sides of it, right?
Sir, one very pertinent question that Ms. Sukriti Arora has asked, and I also have this thing in my mind because I run a WhatsApp group in which I share. People ask me news that are, sort of fake, and I cross-check them and verify them through my different means. She is asking this in context with the information overload, that is there any way to check the bulk messages that we get so often in our, WhatsApp or on social media?
Okay. So, see, information overload will be there. It will increase because it will set the stage for a more launch of the social media platforms because they run on the engine of information overload. And until the information is, crisscrossing their platforms, they will not sustain, right? So it will increase. But yeah, I would like to say that develop and deploy filter at your end, right? There will be information in the space, but what information do you receive? So I have a very famous lecture since 2000. I think it is 2007. I'm giving that lecture on the Google power searching, right? Where, just before receiving the information from the internet, you apply 4 or 5 stages of filter, right? First this, then this, then this, then this, then this, and then the limited amount of information will come to you. And then only then you can, select the result out of that, not out of 200 million results. No, that is not possible, but out of 2000, 3000 or 300, right? So your judgment can apply on 2000 or 3000, not 3 million, clear? For that, you need to create filters, isn't it? And that's so easy, but it's altogether a different lecture.
I think one last question I should take. I have so many questions, but we are running short of time. It is in context with AI. Yesterday, we have a very special, very elaborative session on this AI. So one of the students is asking that AI can be a double-edged sword. On one side, it can help in debunking fake news, and on the other hand, it spreads it further. How can we make sure it is used for good? And do we feel human journalists will be replaced by AI for debunking fake news?
Yeah. Again, see, the AI is opinions, embedded in the codes, right? Simplest way to understand. Opinions embedded into the codes. So when the opinions are there, like I shared, right? Extract a few keywords, isn't it? Okay. Watch out for these kind of exclamation marks, interrogation marks, unnecessary bold letters, unnecessary, my desh, mera mahan, main mahan, Bharat, ye sab kuch. These kind of opinions, they can be encoded into the this thing, na? Algorithms, right? And then when the information is passed through them, so definitely the information which conforms to this will automatically get filtered, yes or no, right? But again, I mean, error margin will also be there, 10 to 15%, but that's okay, right? So again, we need to be aware about the different templates of the misinformation, right? एक टाइम तक बहुत चला था, इसको ज्यादा से ज्यादा फॉरवर्ड करो, कोई रह ना जाए, बट आप देखें अभी जितनी मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन आ रही है, दैट इज स्लाइटली मोर सोफिस्टिकेटेड, इजंट इट? इट डजंट मेंशन नाउ, कि फॉरवर्ड करो नहीं, बिकॉज उनको पता है अब ये पुराना हो चुका है मामला, राइट, चल चुका है, अब कुछ नया आता है इसमें। अभी देशभक्ति का चल रहा था कुछ टाइम तक, बट अभी चूंकि ज्यादा हल्ला हो गया, देन दे विल कम रिप्लेस दिस एंड दे विल रिप्लेस इट विद सम अदर सेंसिबल, सीमिंगली सेंसिबल लॉजिक, राइट, कुछ दिन वो चलेगा एंड देन ये ऐसे चलता है, राइट। सो दीज आर द टेम्पलेट्स, राइट। सो इफ दीज टेम्पलेट्स आर एम्बेडेड इन टू द एल्गोरिथम्स, देन आई थिंक या हो सकता है मामला, व्हाई नॉट।
Sir, it would be very unfair if I would not ask this question, because I have received it from so many participants. It is about audio messages that we receive in on our social media platforms and WhatsApp. What is your take on that, sir? How do debug?
Yes. So my take on that doesn't matter. There is a simple rule as far as fact checking is concerned. Audio messages, we don't verify, right? We can't verify. There is a specialized lab in Hyderabad, Central Science Forensic Lab. You know, they take the voice samples of the suspected people and they match, right? So that's a forensic part. A lot of technical knowledge is there. So in fact-checking trainers, we are taught that, okay, no, this is not our domain, because we don't have the tools. Simply, we don't have the tools, right? We don't have the power to question somebody and take their voice samples, right? Isn't it? For example, Kiran is sitting here now, Professor Kiran. So if I suspect, this is Kiran's voice, right? So what right I have got to seek the sample of Kiran? Tell me, I don't have any. And I don't have the tools thereby, isn't it? So police has all the power. So it is their domain. So we don't venture into that. If at all we venture into that, so I tell you, as far as misinformation is concerned, audio messages are only a fraction, just small fraction, right? So it is left conveniently, right? Only three formats are there, text, video format, that's all, finish.
Thank you so much, sir, for answering all the questions. Now I request Professor Dr. Susmita Bala, Head DME Media School, to kindly give the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Kamil. Thank you, Professor Obesh Arya. Your class is always informative and interesting. I think the students would have understood by how to identify fake images and fake videos, and how to save ourselves from misinformation. काफी तो मैंने भी समझने की कोशिश की है कि इसको कैसे हम क्रॉस चेक करेंगे, कैसे इसको आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे, बट इट्स अ टेक्निकल पार्ट, तो थोड़ा सा और एफर्ट्स करना पड़ेगा. So thank you, sir. Thanks to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Namaste.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the appreciative words. I would now like to thank our guests for an inspiring and informative session. I would also extend my gratitude to Professor Dr. B. Saxena, Dean DME Media School, conveyor Icon Ford, and Professor Dr. Susmita Bala, Head DME Media School, Chief Conveyor, for the ideation and planning of the sessions. I would like to thank Ms. Manmeet Kaur, Dr. Manasvi Maheshwari, Mohammed Kamal, and Ms. Sukhti V.S. for their constant support and guidance. I would also like to thank Mr. Ritik Ghosh, Mr. Sumantra Sarthi Das, Mr. Sachin Nair, and Mr. Yogesh Sharma for providing overall digital operations for Icon 4. I would also like to thank our newsletter and media team, comprising of both students and faculty member like Ms. Krishna Pandey, Mohammed Kamal, Ms. Sukriti Arora, and Dr. Chinam Bora. I would also like to thank Mr. Anmol Mehta for tirelessly working in making our events look more beautiful digitally, so with the help of prolific designs. I would now like to thank our entire team and all faculty members and students who work day and night, facing all the challenges and obstacles of the pandemic in making this conference happen. I must also thank all the participants who joined the session. And here we complete the first day of four of the second edition of the world's first 10-day Digital Life International Conference, Icon 4. We are looking forward to six more days filled with knowledge, expertise, and deliberations on the diversity of topics. In the afternoon at 3 p.m., we have a masterclass also on the topic Health Communication by Mr. Nimesh Kapoor, Senior Scientist, Vigyan Prasad, Government of India. This session will be followed by technical session 3, and the theme for the session is Women Emancipation, Gender Issues, LGBTQ Rights. Stay tuned with us for our upcoming session. Thank you.